Hello friends, welcome to the home learning platform of Hebron. This is our second video of BA, 11th standard BA, that is also known as OC, Organization of Commerce. Now, in the last video, we have seen the meaning of economic activity, non-economic activity, difference between the economic activity and non-economic activity. Then we have seen that economic activities can be of three types: business, profession, and employment. In that case, we have seen the meaning and characteristics of business. Now, it's time to undertake the study of upcoming questions. And our next topic of today's lecture is objectives of business. Objective means reasons, intentions, purpose. That why an individual carry out any economic activity with the purpose of profit. That why we are indulged in an economic activity called business. So, here are the objectives of business. Now students, objectives can be of two types: economic objectives and social objectives. Economic objectives and social objectives. Social objectives are also known as non-economic objectives. Let us undertake the study of all these objectives one by one. The first is profit. In the definition of business, in the meaning of business itself, we have seen that any legal economic activity carried out with the purpose of profit is known as business. Means it implies, it goes without saying that a business is carried out for the purpose of profit only. Profit is the barometer of any business. Profit is the measurement of efficiency of any business. Means if we want to measure the efficiency of a business, then the profit is must. But the thing is, a profit, but the reasonable profit. Now in this era of competition, if you will charge excess amount of profit, you want to be acceptable to the customers. So if you want to be acceptable to the customers, an adequate amount, that is a reasonable amount of profit is required. Reasonable amount of profit is required for the existence of the business. Reasonable amount of profit is required to pay the expenses of the business. Reasonable amount of profit is required to pay all the necessary amount to the related parties. Means, without profit, we cannot imagine the existence of a business. It is a lifeblood of business. Like a human body without blood. In the same way, a business without profit. It is the backbone of any business. A good amount of profit. That's a reasonable amount. So, profit is the first economic objective of any business. The number one was profit. Number two, maximization of wealth. The concept of profit is a short-term concept. It is an annual concept. Like in accountancy, in the upcoming chapters, you learn that there are two types of profit, gross profit and the net profit. And that profits are also calculated on an annual basis. So when it comes to the concept of profit, it's a short-term concept. But when it comes to the concept of wealth, maximization of wealth, creation of wealth, that is a long-term concept. See, in the time of depression, in the time of slack period, like during this corona pandemic, when people are not having a good business with them, the business of the country or the economic situation is down. At that time, we cannot target for the profit, but we can target for the maximization of wealth. We can focus on those projects which will give return in the longer period, not a return in the short period. So, no doubt, profit is also required, but sometime a creation of wealth is more important than the profit. So business has to satisfy, business has to fulfill both the objective, that is number one, profit, and number two, maximization of wealth. Number three, others. Now, others' economic objectives can be growth of business, development of business, modernization, expansion. If the technology changes, then we have to keep a pace with the changing technology. Gradually, we need to change. If we will be with the old technology and our competitors have introduced new technology, then it's but obvious that the entire business or the few customers will approach the competitor. The sale of our product will decrease. So other economic objectives are, it can be growth and development of business, it can be modernization, it can be upgradation of technology, and it can be expansion of business. So these three are the economic objective of any business. Number one, profit. Number two, maximization of wealth. And number three, other economic objectives. Now, B, social objectives. A business develops within the society. A business is due to society. So if we ignore this important element, that is a social objectives, then we won't be able to survive for a longer period. No doubt we have some economic objectives. We have to fulfill those objectives, but along with economic objectives, few social objectives are also to be fulfilled. Like number one, social responsibility. Social responsibility consists of responsibility of the business to each and every party related to business. Let it be customers, employees, suppliers, government, researchers, all the stakeholders of business. A business has some responsibilities towards them. A business has to carry out some social activities for the different stakeholders of the business. They have to carry out the workers' scheme. They have to carry out certain welfare activities for the employees. They have to give something back to the society. Every time, you cannot fetch only from the society. When you are well off, when you are getting a good profit, then it's a time to give back to the society. Whatever we have gained from the society, a part of it must be returned to the society in any form. In any form you need. Let it be in the form of donation. Let it be in the form of education. Let it be in the form of certain charities to be carried out during natural calamities. You can do it in any way. So number one is social responsibility. Number two, employment opportunities. Now, as we all know, in India, unemployment is the biggest issue. Every political party at the time of election, they will give one strong promise. Hum rojgari denge, we will give employment. But we know still, it's a 2020. India is facing one of the greatest issue, and that is unemployment. So if that unemployment is to be removed or reduced from the society, removal is quite not possible, but reduction is possible. So we want to reduce that unemployment. We want to convert that unemployment into an employment. Then business plays an important role. There are many businesses in society. Those who are constantly trying to generate the employment. Even nowadays, government is also providing incentives. Government is also motivating, encouraging those entrepreneurs who want to set up their business in the backward areas. Those who want to promote the youth of the backward area. Those who want to do their economic activities in those areas where and employment is still a dream. So number two is employment opportunity, that is generation of employment opportunity. Now number three, quality goods and services. Yes, Nowadays, customers are ready to pay more. Nowadays, customers are ready to pay a good amount if you are capable of supplying quality goods and services. Customers can compromise with the price, but nowadays, customers cannot compromise with the quality. Yes, we cannot compromise with the quality. If two products are available in the market, and if we feel that by our experience or by our observation that the later one product is far better than the former one, and if we need to pay more price towards that, we will pay, but we will demand for the better quality of product. So it is the responsibility, it is a social responsibility of any producer to provide quality goods, especially in case of food products. As we all know, it is directly related to the health of the consumer. A producer supplying the spices, McDonald's, Domino's, any other eatery outlet nearby your house or in the market, customers demand good quality from them. They demand qualitable products from them. They demand healthy product from them. And when it comes to qualitable services, so after sale services, home delivery of product at the doorstep of the customer at a very reasonable price, or free home delivery of the goods. You might have observed that when you go to buy TV, refrigerator or AC, that shopkeeper are offering free delivery. They are not charging any amount for the delivery. It can also come under the category of quality services. So the third non-economic or the social objective is quality goods and services. Now, the fourth one is fair trade practices. Yes, you might have seen advertisement on the TV that फेयर एंड लवली अपनाइए और पांच हफ्तों में चार हफ्तों में मनचाहा निखार पाइए. दीज आर द मिसलीडिंग एडवर्टीजमेंट. और ड्यूरिंग दिस लॉकडाउन यू माइट हैव ऑब्जर्व द प्राइस ऑफ द ग्रीन, द प्राइस ऑफ द वेजिटेबल्स, द प्राइस ऑफ द ऑयल, दे वर टचिंग द स्काई. अ टीन विच वॉज अवेलेबल एट द रेट ऑफ 1000 ड्यूरिंग लॉकडाउन इट वॉज अवेलेबल एट 1500. सो दिस वॉज ब्लैक मार्केटिंग. It was hoarding. It was storing the excess goods and creating an artificial shortage of the goods. Means, Shuddh Gujarati ma kaada bazar, black marketing. So this must not be undertaken by any business. It is not the fair practice, it is unfair trade practice. Though it is illegal, it is an punishable offense, still some businessmen are doing. So if you want to give something to the society, over and above the qualitable goods and services, a businessman must emphasize on fair trade practices. There should not be any misleading advertisement. There should not be any statement in exaggeration. If you consume our product, you will lose your weight within 7 days. If you will consume our product, you will gain your weight in 7 days. These all are misleading advertisement and they fall under the category of unfair trade practice. So as a businessman, you must promote fair trade practices if you want to survive. Because we have cleared in the last lecture, consumer is the king of market. The days have gone where producer were producing and the customers were buying. Now the time is whatever a customer demands, that a producer has to supply. So consumer is the king of market. Number 5, others. Other social objectives like regular bonus to the employees, incentives to the employees, education facilities for the children of employees, health facility, canteen facility at the premises. These all are social objectives. So here our topic of objectives of business, A, economic, B, non-economic objective gets over. In economic objectives, we have seen 3 points: profit, maximization of wealth, and others. Then in non-economic objective, we have seen 1, social responsibility; 2, employment opportunities; 3, qualitable goods and services; 4, fair trade practices; and 5, others. Now, the next question is business risk. Now, risk is a very familiar term. Many of times we have heard the risk and uncertainty. These 2 points are the characteristic of any economic activity. But in business, this risk element is more than the profession and the employment. In business, there are chances of no profit, there are chances of less profit, there are uncertainty of loss. Yes, future is totally uncertain. We cannot 100% predict the future. We can have an estimation. We can have an estimation for the future, but when it comes to perfect prediction, we can't do that because future is uncertain. Anything can happen in future. There are chances from 5 crore profit, a business can jump to 50 crore. And there are chances a business getting 50 crore profit can fall down to 5 crore profit. This is risk. And the risk associated to business can be of 2 types. A, natural risk. B, man-made risk. Now, natural risk. The risk which is not within the control of human being. The risk which is beyond the control of human being. The risk which cannot be controlled. The activity that cannot be controlled, like earthquake, flood, famine, drought, tsunami, cyclone. Yes, when it is raining heavily. So we are not getting any pre-messages that after 1 hour it will rain heavily. So please plan for that. Even the reports from the weather department, it's not 100% fact. When a weather department says tomorrow it will be a good rain, it won't rain. When weather department says there won't be any rain and it will be a good rain. So we can't even predict anything on the basis of the prediction done by the different department. So natural risk, which is not within the control of business. B, man-made risk. Now, when it comes to man-made risk, a very first question that comes to our mind is it possible that the man himself will create certain uncertainty for the business? Yes, the answer is yes. The very first that comes to our mind is strike. Strike of employees. Yes, it's a man-made risk. You might have seen in the movies, the workers are sitting in front of the factory gate and they are yelling loudly, "Hamari mange puri karo." Yes, like that. So it's an example of strike, and strike is an example of man-made risk. It can be change in demand. It can be change in taste and preference. It can be change in technology. It can be change in government also. Yes, political risk. These all are man-made risk. So business risk means the risk arising out of the uncertainty. And the profit that we are getting, it is the reward for such uncertainty. And risk can be of 2 types. 1, natural risk. 2, man-made risk. So the second topic was business risk and the types of business risk. 1, natural risk. B, man-made risk. Now, causes of business risk. What are the reasons? What are the causes? Why risk arises in business? So we have to undertake 6 points, 6 causes. 1, that is change in technology. It's a very common man-made risk, change in technology. And this risk you might have faced while buying your cell phone. It's a very easy example that can be understood by you people in an easiest manner. Whenever we have bought our new cell phone, we are trying to buy as latest version as possible. But the moment we purchase, after a few days, when a new model launches in the market, our version becomes outdated. And it is also applicable in all other technological products and the electronic gadgets. And nowadays, it is also applicable for any kind of production of any goods. When technology changes, you need to be updated with the changed technology. In place of old technology, you need to replace that with the new technology. So number one is change in technology. Number two, threat of substitute product. There are chances that due to change in the technology, customers shift their demand from our product to the substitute product. For example, a company producing typewriters. Had faced business risk when the computers were launched in the market, when computers were for the very first time introduced in the market. So it was a threat to the typewriter producing companies, because those individuals which were making the use of typewriters, after the invention of computers, after the introduction of computers to the Indian market, the demand of typewriters were decreasing, and the customers were shifting their demands from typewriters to the computers. Then, number three, competition. As we all know, it's an open market. There is a free entry and free exit. Any person can start the new business. Any person can enter into a market at any time. You cannot stop anyone. You cannot stop anyone entering into the market. Even the giant companies like Reliance, Tata cannot do that. Because it's a competitive world. So when degree of competition increases, when new producers, new rival firms enters into the market, at that time, there is a risk of profit. See, previously, a biscuit manufacturing company was only one, and that one was Parle-ji. Later on, Sunfist entered into the market. Tiger company entered into the market, and Parle-ji have to incur huge expenditure after the advertisement. After the promotion of the product. So when a huge amount is spent after advertisement, spent after the promotion, the profit available with the producer decreases. Now no firm can get abnormal profit. All are getting an adequate amount of profit as the market is open for all. Number four, legislation, that is government control. For example, Factory Act. For example, Minimum Wages Act. For example, any Safety or Remuneration Act. Any act passed by the government, passed by the legislative body, is having a strong impact on business. A very good example is, after some issues with China, Indian government has stopped import of various products. So those businessmen who were dealing in the Chinese product in India, those who were making the import of Chinese product and supplying the same across the India, now they are facing a serious issue. They don't have any business to do due to the legislative action by the government. Then number 5, uncertainty of demand. In economics also we have seen that the factors affecting demand, and here demand is the influencing factor. That is, when it comes to business risk, uncertainty of demand is a strong factor. In a market, demand is totally uncertain. There are chances that the yesterday you have sold 5,000 unit and today your sale was only for 2,000 unit. And there are chances that tomorrow your sale will be from 2,000 units to the 20,000 unit. A demand is influenced by various factors. A demand changes, profit changes. If the demand of our product is good, we'll be getting a good profit. But if the demand falls or if the demand contracts, then the profit margin reduces, and that results into business risk. Last but not the list is number 6, that is physical risk. Now, physical risk means loss to the property, damage to the property, breakdown of any asset, breakdown of any machine, or maybe there are chances that due to transportation, in transit, it get damaged, or due to certain activities at the business, by some natural reason, the machines or any assets got damaged. So number 6 is physical risk. Let us revise the last two questions. Business risk can be of two types: A, natural risk; B, man-made risk. Causes of business risk: number 1, change in the technology; number 2, threat of substitute products; number 3, competition; number 4, legislation; number 5, uncertainty of demand; and number 6, physical risk. Thank you.